Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Oblong Polka Dots and my name is Kerr. And on this channel, we talk about makeup, skincare, and beauty. So if that's something you're into, you've come to the right place. A couple things. My window is open because it's hot. It's hot in here. So you're going to hear birds, you're going to hear cars and people and all that great stuff. Today, I want to use the She's In Potties palette by Melt Cosmetics. I've had my eye on this palette for a long time. And I just didn't purchase it because I felt like it was a little bit overpriced for what they were offering. When I did receive the palette, it was broken. So I did my best to mush the shadows back into place, but this is what it looks like. And you've seen this before. It's definitely an oldie but a goodie, but it's new to me. So we're going to use it today. I'm kind of excited. I've waited a really long time for this palette, so... First though, let's get to prepping and priming and all that great stuff. We're going to go ahead and prime the eyes with the Essence Prime Like a Boss eyeshadow base. If you've been to my channel before, you know I'm obsessed with this primer. It's so good and it's super inexpensive and it just punches above its weight. When you go to put it on, don't freak out because it's kind of oily, but it does dry down and it does get tacky and it will keep your shadow from creasing. And it will hold it in place all day. All day. So I love this stuff. I buy mine at Ulta because Ulta will typically have sales where it's like buy more and save. So you can like buy two, get one free. Are we crooked? Am I imagining that we're crooked? Do I do this every video, you guys? It's just because I have to like move stuff around every time I film. We're good. We're good. Let's just stick with it. So next, I'm going to go ahead and use up the rest of my Fenty Pro Filter Instant Retouch Primer. I love this stuff. I didn't like it when I first bought it, though. I talked big bad trash about it. Now I'm like, you know, sorry, this is really good. I don't know if my skin changed or what. Oh, good. I got two good pumps out of this. Maybe I have a little bit more. But I love it. I love it. I love it. So to me... It feels very moisturizing and it's just like, it just feels good on the skin. And I like the way that my foundation sits over it. So, all of those things. And as always, I always start off with a clean face. It's already been cleaned and moisturized and primed and sunscreened and all that good stuff. Because we do wear sunscreen over here every day. We wear sunscreen every day. All right, so we have primers on, feeling good about that. Let's just begin. What colors are we going to pick, you guys? I normally do my makeup in a gradient. Recently, I've had a couple people ask me to do a colorful look, so maybe I can try and pack in as many of these colors as possible, just starting with lightest from the inside and then darkest to the outside. So let's just see what we can come up with. I have no plan. None. Just... out here just wiling out, you guys. Let me get a flat brush, big old flat brush. I'm gonna start off with, how about a base color? We'll just start with that and then we'll work our way up. So this one is called Total Immortal right here, and we're just gonna start with that. It's like a really pretty kind of milky sort of powdery purple, and we're gonna lay that all over the lid. Yes, there is fallout. Definitely. Can you see that? We got fallout. Yes, we do. But we also have a really nice pigment. Look how pretty. Wow. But you know, Melt Cosmetics is known for their mattes. So I don't know why I'm acting all brand new or surprised. I really shouldn't be. This is what they're known for. I'm going to take it up a little bit. Just a scotch into that crease. Same thing for the other side. Just going to take it up a little bit. I really don't know where this look is going, you guys, but I'm glad that you're here to be on the journey with me as we discover what it is we can do. So, yeah, that is a beautiful, bright purple matte. I'm feeling very 80s with this shadow on my lid, and I am not mad. I think it's a lovely base. Why don't we go in with, how about we grab a different brush? Let's get a fluffy brush. And we take this color into the crease. Why not? Let's go crazy, get nuts. So the color that's next to it is called Last Caress. Last Caress. And we're gonna pop that into the crease using a fluffy brush. Let's fluffy it up a little bit. And we know we're gonna get fallout and we're fine with that, right? We've all discussed it. Everybody's on board. We're all on the same page with that. Can you see that? We're not putting too much on. We're just trying to build that color up because this is one of those colors I can tell. If you go crazy, get nuts, then there's no going back. It's just going to dominate. So we're picking up a little bit at a time just to start giving that crease a little dimension. There we go. I hope it's picking up on camera. Hold on. Can you see that? Can you see it's picking up? No? Yes? Let me know. Put on a little bit more. Oh yeah, that should be picking up now. Getting a little bit deeper there. It's getting deep. Again, Melt is known for their mattes, so I'm not too scared of working with this, but I also don't want to go super duper overboard with it either. I'm just trying to work my way up. Trying to add in that nice pretty aubergine to the crease. Okay, I think that's good. Do a little bit more on this side. Don't want to go completely overboard, but I do want to make sure that color is present. I do like it. Wow. It's so subtle. It's really soft. I hope that it's picking up on camera. It's very pretty. But again, I don't want to get carried away. I can see that it's really easy to get carried away, though. This is one of those shades where it's like, oh, I'll just do a little bit more. And next thing you know, you've got like a complete smoky eye. You're going grunge. You're Seattle in the 90s. You're just in there doing it. Courtney Love ain't got nothing on you. Okay, I think that's good. I don't want to go overboard. So what are we going to pick up next, you guys? How about, ooh, let's grab our flat brush again. And we're going to go in with, actually, let's get a smaller, fluffier, dense brush. We're going to pick this one because I want to go into the outer corner with this color. This is an aubergine. It's called Mean Streak right here. And yeah, let's try that. So we're taking a little time. We're going to take a little bit. When I say a little bit, I mean, all I did was like touch the brush to the pan, like a little tiny, ouch, hit my elbow, a little tiny bit because I can already see where this is going. And we're just going to try working that into the outer corner and see what it do. Trying to get that C shape going. Yeah, see what I mean? I knew it. I knew it. A little tiny bit. All I did was tap the pan. Just tapped it. That's all I did. And already, I know you can see it. This is the business right here. Good grief. Yeah, this is the one you have to be super careful with because otherwise, that's a wrap. So we're just going to stick to that same kind of V shape that I'm making out here on the outer corner, or C shape, however you want to view it. And we're just working that really beautiful, dense color into that outer corner. Same thing on this side. It's nice. Oh, I'm telling you, I think Melt really has the matte shadow game hemmed up. Although I have to say, their formula isn't always consistent. So when you're looking at these palettes, you really should only be looking at them for the mattes and then just kind of like praying for the shimmers. You know what I mean? Shimmers are not their strength, but mattes are. So if you want some really beautiful non-patchy mats, then I definitely recommend Melt. We're going to clean all this up too, don't worry. I'm just trying not to go too overboard. Trying is the key word here. But I can tell you, beyond the shadow of a doubt, pardon the pun, that these colors work very well together. They blend beautifully. Yes. Yes. This is good. This is good, you guys. All right, so now let's try and grab a new color. How about we go with, let's start fiddling around with these shimmers because there's only three mattes in the palette and I laid all three mattes down on my lid already. So I guess we're going to have to go with the satins. So before we do that though, here's what I want to do. I'm going to grab some of this NYX glitter primer. I'm going to put a little bit of that on my lid using this flat brush right here. Because whatever I lay down next, I really want it to sparkle and shine. I want it to be the star of the show. This is the best glitter primer. I love this stuff. When I say that whatever you put on top of it is going to stick, whatever you put on top of it is going to stick, and you don't need much at all. Tiny little bit, you guys. Do not go overboard with this because a little bit goes a very, very long ways. And I'm just coming over the lid where the color is lightest using a tiny little bit of this. And if you can see, it's already tacky. Like by the time I tap it the second or third time, it's like lifting up my eyelid gently, but it is tacky. So it's going to hold on to whatever. Okay. Little tiny bit more just to make sure I really got it in there. Okay, that's good. So now let's go in and take a look at these satins and see what we want to do. Again, Melt Cosmetics is not known for like a strong satin formula, so I want to give these shades the best possible opportunity to really shine on my lid. I'm actually going to start off with this one on the end. It's called Lost Control. It's this one right here. And we are going to start on the outside. We're going to grab one of these same brushes, this flat one right here. I'm using the same side and I'm just going to pop a little bit on there. I'm going to show you what it looks like so you can see. And we're going to take that out here. And all I'm doing is patting it down. I'm not doing anything more than that. And then coming up just a little bit and I'm staying at an angle. And there's definitely fallout from this. Okay. That's the first bit of glitter. Next, I'm going to go in with this shade called Sleepwalk right here. And we're going to put that right next to the shade that we just used, same brush. Just a little bit. Putting it next to slash on top of so we can get a gradient effect. And see how I'm not really taking up too much space. I'm just going in with a little bit. We're just edging our way in with these colors. And again, I'm kind of staying at an angle with this. There we go. I want to leave plenty of room for the other colors to be laid down. So it's kind of like a stripe. Okay. Can you see where we're going with this? Can you see where we're headed? Where we're on our way to? You get the map? Okay. Next, we're going to go with the namesake of the palette. It's She's in Parties, and that's this one right here. And we're just going to lay that right next to the other two that we just laid down. Same brush. It's going to go like this. There we go. It's coming right up to that crease. I have to say that this side is a lot nicer looking than this side, but that's fine. We're going to clean it up in a minute. There we go. Trying to make sure that it's as balanced as possible. Can you see that? Okay, so now we're going to go in with this other shimmer. It's called Strange Love. This is one of the ones that broke. It's right here. And we're going to lay that right down next to the other two. Same brush. Isn't that nice when you don't have to reach for another brush? Since this one is broken, I'm trying to be really careful and just kind of pat my brush more than anything. And it definitely has fallout, just so you know. We're just laying that right next to the other color. Right there. Okay, to the other side. There we go. Right? Can you see that? I really like the way it looks. But there is definitely fallout, so we're going to have to do some serious cleaning up. Okay, now we have one more. Wow, we managed to use every color, you guys. I love that. Oh my gosh. We're going to put this flat brush away. We can grab another one if we need it. And now we're going to go in with this inner corner color. It's called Skeleton Kisses. So for this one, there it is. I need a small brush, a much smaller brush. So why don't we use this one? This one's pretty tiny. And we're going to use that for the inner corner. Love it when that happens. We're able to use every color in the palette. Woo! Yep, glad I grabbed a small brush. This is bright. Take a little down here. There we go. Wow. What do you think? I like it. Same thing for this side. Just gonna pull that in. If I had to give this color a description, I would say it reminds me of a pink cotton candy. I think that's probably the best way to describe it. Just bringing this up a little bit. It's very sparkly. It's very pink. And I love it. This is definitely one of those colors I gravitate towards in my looks. Just to brighten them up a little bit, you know? Put a little bit more here. I was going to use this for my brow bone, but I think it's a bit much. Because it is daytime, and this isn't necessarily a daytime look. For the evening, I probably could pull it off, but not today, kids. All right, what do you think? I think it's good. I think that's exactly what I wanted, like a gradient look. So now that we've pulled that off, and you used every color, you were there, you saw the whole thing, we used every single color. Let's go in, we're going to set the palette aside just for a minute, put some of these brushes away that we made a mess with, keep this one out because, remember that fluffy brush we were using earlier? I'm going to go right back in with that first color, Total Immortal. I'm just dipping the brush and I'm going right back here, right above all of those colors, just to pull it in and at least have some kind of tie-in for each of these. Same with this side. Just trying to blend it out. There we go. And I'm doing that because I want it to have some consistency just across the eye so that really it's just the lid where you're getting that gradient and the rest of the eye is a little more stationary, a little more stable. Is it dramatic or what? Honey, this is a dramatic look. I like this palette. I think it's really pretty. And I think that the colors actually stand alone or can be used with other palettes. So I do recommend it if you can get your hands on it. But I think that I was smart to wait because I do believe that what I paid for it, I think that was the right price. I don't think that I would have paid full price for it. And I'm glad that I waited. So we're going to grab a towelette. Trying not to make too much of a mess here. And we're going to clean up some of this fallout. Because, yes, this fallout is definitely real. It's not too bad, but you know, it's you can see it. I know you can see it. It's a bit much. A little bit more. And nice and gentle. Here we go. All right. Cleaned up. Not bad. Anything else? It's that glitter. That's what I meant. Like, Melt does mattes, no problem. I think that they just get on the struggle bus when it comes to the glitter. So, if you're looking for these palettes, you're looking for the mattes. That's what you're looking for. I'm gonna actually do my liner first. So I'm grabbing this Love Drug from Urban Decay. It's one of my favorites, and I think it goes well with these colors. And I don't typically line my lower lash line. I typically just stick to my upper lash line. And the reason I don't often line my lower lash line is I feel like it ages me. And I don't need to be aged any more than I'm aging, you know? So I'm already 44, so we're good. We are doing the aging thing without getting help, so to speak. Little bit more, so just a little. Don't poke your eye out, that kind of thing. I do have to be careful with these because I love a pencil that is like a pencil that you have to sharpen. But you know, if you're not careful and you don't sharpen it, like this wood, it can like poke you. So you know that though. I'm explaining things to you already know. I'll be quiet. Okay, what do you think? It just kind of makes the lashes a little more like something. It's like a little fuller, something along those lines. Okay, so we need some concealer. I'm gonna go with the Lancôme Tinted Dull Ultra Wear All Over Concealer. This is in the shade 470. You've seen it before on my channel. I love it. And we're going underneath here. Just like this. And we're going to let it sit there for a minute and brighten up a little. And I know I have some color corrector somewhere. I just opened it, but I forgot to grab it. So we're just going to do this for today. And then in my next video, I'll make sure to put the color corrector in my compass case so that I remember to reach for it. But today, this is what we're doing, which is fine. Right, so let's let that dry up a little bit. I do have a little treat here for us that I haven't tried yet that we can use. It's the Blushberry Radiant. It's the e.l.f. Halo Beauty Wand Blush with the cushion applicator. I haven't used these yet. And I bought this one. I bought the contour and the highlighter. So I thought it would be fun today to try out the blush. So we're going to give that a try. And I need... Did I not grab a sponge? Not one? Nowhere? None? Okay. Let's do a brush then. This is the Morphe M173. It's my favorite brush for blending my concealer. And there's just something about it. When I thought that Morphe was going out of business, I actually purchased a ton of these so that I would have backups for in the future. But clearly they're still selling products, so I may have panicked for no reason. There we go. See how that blends in? And it just looks like skin. Can you see it? That is why I love this concealer. I also love it because it comes in a very wide range. Not only a wide range of colors, but a nice wide range of undertones. Because we need to have variety. Skin comes in varied tones and colors. So if we could just get more brands to understand that and cater to the full spectrum, that would be helpful. From my sisters from another mister that are really, really pale, to my beautiful, deep, chocolatey, ebony goddesses, we need a spectrum, okay? We need a full spectrum, you guys. Cosmetic industry. Okay, I think that's good. Very skin-like, right? Yay, skin-like! Okay, so we are going to set this with the Black Radiance Soft Finishing Powder in 9201 Golden Almond. I've had this for a really long time. I just didn't use it until recently, so I'm not sure why, and I'm just pressing this. And then I'm just going to press this on because we really don't want too much powder. Because too much powder gives you that like dry, cakey look. And I still want it to look somewhat like skin, to have, you know, some suppleness to it. I'm not putting any foundation on today, so this it. I'm not covering my melasma. I'm not covering any other imperfections that you may see on my face. Because sometimes I just want to walk around looking normal, you know, looking like somebody that has zits and freckles and moles, and just, you know, I'm not trying to cover it up, just trying to show you my face. I'm gonna pop over to this little blush that we're gonna try today. Let's try it out. Ooh, don't break your nail, girl. I know that a lot of people bought these when they first came out. I just bought mine and promptly left it in the box. Figured I'd get to it when I get to it. I do like e.l.f. products though, so I'm hoping that I enjoy this. And I'm really trying to get into using more liquids and creams because I feel like variety is the spice of life. I don't know why I can't open this box, you guys. They sell it to you, but they don't want you to use it. Tearing it open like a little kid. What a train wreck. Oof. There we go. Let's see what this looks like. I'm thinking that I should probably not stick it on my face, and instead I should stick it on my hand. Now, I know a lot of people talked about, I don't know if you can see that, but the wand has like something here on top, and you're supposed to like turn it or click it or something. You think I would have read the instructions? Probably should have read the instructions. It's making a click noise. Let's see if I can squeeze it all. Yes. So it is coming out of the ends, and I'm afraid to put this on my face, so I'm going to try putting this on my hand first. Oops. Ooh, it's messy. See? That's why I put it on my hand first. I gave it another little squeeze and it's a little bit much. So now we know what we're working with. Oh my God, that's a lot of product. Let's close this cap. and see if we can salvage this little train wreck that I just created. I'm just dipping my brush in, and I'm actually like just going like this because I really don't want that much on my face. Huh. Okay. It's a controlled experiment. There we go. Ooh. Hello. Oh, I like it. Can you guys see that? It's not nearly as crazy as I thought it was going to be. I thought I was seriously about to have a problem, but no, this is nice. It goes on beautifully. Oh, it's building up. Look at that. Ooh. Okay. I see you, Elf. I see you. Still trying to be, you know, cautious, but I see you. Nope. Got a bit much up there. We'll have to deal with that in a minute. I do like this, though. Look at that. So glowy. Oh my goodness. Okay, so since we're going with the graphic look, let's try and mimic this side. And that side. We'll come back in with the powder and tone that down in a second, but I like it. It's very glowy. What do you think? That was a lot of product that was on my hand, but it surprisingly was, I could work with it. So we're going to try and clean up this little extra dab over here. But first, let's wipe off my hand so I don't get this everywhere. And it comes off easily. I just wiped it off with a wipe. Can I do it up here too? Yep. Oh, there we go. Okay. No problem. Huh. I think I was worried for no reason. We're going to take this little powder puff. We're just going to tone that down a little. And no one will be the wiser. Tone it down over here too. Oh, nice. Okay. Yes. I recommend this so far. If it wears well, I'll use it again. If it doesn't wear well, you'll probably never see it again. But right now, it's pretty. It's got a glow. It's like literally, it's a blush with a highlighter in it. You know what I mean? So you could just kill two birds with one stone. I like it. All right, let's finish up, shall we? Because I'm over here really talking your guys' ear off. I have this Bad Gal Bang mascara. I have the smaller one. I went on a little mascara purchasing binge, trying to see if there were other formulas I liked besides the Essence formula or that I liked more, really. And I'm not finding any. And that includes high-end brands. So Essence for the win. I change my mascara a lot, and I don't necessarily want to spend a ton of money on mascara that I'm going to throw away in 1 to 2 months. So I feel like Essence is really able to fill that need nicely with a high quality mascara at a low price. And if I play my cards right, when I buy it from Ulta, I buy it on sale where they have the buy two get one free. However, I do like this mascara. I have to be careful with this type of wand though, because I'm telling you guys, I'd be poking my eye out and it's like watering and red and hurts. And every once in a while I go so far into the whole poking my eye out thing that I will have to take off my makeup completely because my eye is irritated for the day. So we're just going to be careful. There we go. The other thing is, I do like this formula because it's wet, and I like a wet mascara. There's a lot of people that don't because they have really long eyelashes, and it can tend to spread all over the place if you're not careful, but I do like it. And I don't have to dip the wand back into the tube. I'm just using the same amount of product that was deposited initially. There we go. What do you think? Do you like it? Is this a pretty dramatic look? I like it. I love purple, so I feel like, it's purple, so what's not to like? I like this look. Let's put a neutral lip on, though, shall we? Let's not go overboard with the lip. I like the blush, you guys. I keep looking at it in the mirror. I like it. I like it. Is that art? Yeah, like Picasso, whatever the meme says. Let's go with a tried and true over here. I know. Isn't she boring? This is from Fenty and it's the color Fussy. It's just a gloss, but I really like this gloss. So we'll use this. There we go. Just something plain. I tend to stick with something plain on the lip when the eyes are the star of the show. So that's why we're going to go plain here. Let me know what you think, you guys. I actually really like this look. Thank you for asking me to do something a little more colorful. I forgot how much I love colors. I love neutrals, but y'all, I'm going to have to jump into some colors for the summer, huh? Thank you so much for joining me. I really appreciate your time. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share, and I will talk to you soon. Take care.